Welcome back, my dear students. I am going to discuss on the topic life cycle, pathogenicity, and control measures of Fasciola hepatica. Fasciola hepatica is a common liver fluke and that is found in liver and bile ducts of cattle, sheep, goat, pig, rabbit, dog, etc. It causes damage to the liver tissue, producing liver rot in all sheep breeding area of the world. Its life cycle is completed in two hosts, a vertebrate host. The vertebrate host is generally sheep, that is a primary host, and the snail like planorbis, limnia, and bullinus that act as an intermediate host, and it is occasionally found in man. Liver flukes are commonly named as digenetic trematodes as they have two different modes of reproduction. Sexual mode of reproduction that's happen in the sheep. So that is a definitive host, and another intermediate host are the snail, where the larval development proceeds. Now, what are the morphology of the Fasciola hepatica? It is a large lip-shaped fluke that's measuring 3 centimeters in the length and 1.5 centimeters in the breadth. The color brown to pale gray in color. There are two suckers. That's a oral sucker, that is a smaller sucker, and this is a large sucker, that is a ventral sucker, also known as acetabulum. It is responsible for attachment to the host body. The anterior end bears oral sucker that forms a conical projection. This is a conical projection. And the posterior end is rounded. Intestinal cica bears a number of lateral compound branches. These are the compound branches, see here. Hermaphrodite, generally, testes are situated one behind the other in the middle part of the body. The branch tubercle lies in the front of the anterior testes. These are the testes you see here. The genital aperture or the gonopore, this is a genital opening that is situated just anterior side of the ventral portion. At the posterior end of the body, there is excretory pore for excretion of the nitrogenous waste products. Lifespan of the adult worm in case of the sheep 5 years, whereas in case of the human, it is 9 to 13 years. The eggs are the large, ovoid in shape, operculated, brownish in color. It possesses a big unsegmented ovum in a mass of yolk cell. The egg is excreted within bile in the duodenum and then passes out with fecal matter. The eggs can further develop only in water. Now, the life cycle, that's a consists of two different hosts. Definitive host, that is a primary host, sheep, goat, cattle, man, adult worm stays in the biliary passage of the liver. Reservoir host is basically sheep. Whereas the intermediate host may be limnia, planorbis, or bullinus, where the larval development proceeds. Immature eggs, that's a passes out the fecal matter of the definitive host and contaminate water. Within 9 to 15 days, at 22 to 25 degrees centigrade, a ciliated Myrasidium larva, this is a ciliated Myrasidium larva, that comes out from the egg, and the Myrasidium can live in the water only for 8 hours and finds its suitability intermediate host. That's a search for intermediate host. There's a limnia, planorbis, or bullinus. Now, inside the limb passages of the snail, the Myrasidium goes through the stages. Sporocyst, you see here sporocyst, first and second generation of the ruddy, then finally bland tail Sarcaria. The whole cycle takes place a period of 30 to 60 days. The mature Sarcaria escape from the snail into the water and begin to swim and ultimately encyst as metasarcaria. This is the encystment, metasarcaria. That is present in the blades of the grass or any kinds of the water crash. Now, metasarcaria may remain viable for a long time and are ingested along with the aquatic plants by herbivore animals and occasionally by man. On entering the digestive tract of metasarcaria, exists in the duodenum within 48 hours and migrate through the intestinal wall into the peritoneal cavity, penetrate the capsule of the liver, and ultimately settle in the biliary passage and grow to sexual maturity. The incubation period between the ingestion and metasarcaria by the vertebrate host and Development of the adult flux is about 3 to 4 months. Now the cycle is repeated again and again. In human infection, fasciolosis includes biliary colic with vomiting, persistent diarrhea, and hepatomegaly. The mature worms in biliary passage may interfere with the normal flow of bile, causing obstructive jaundice. They cause marked pathological changes in the biliary tract by mechanical irritation, as well as by their toxic secretion. The biliary epithelium proliferates, giving rise to adenoma. It causes hepatitis, hemorrhage in case of sheep. It causes liver rot disease. You see here, that is a liver rot, because of which the sheep becomes weak. And what are the treatment? Bithionol, triclobendazole are the drug of choice. The dose of the bithionol is 1 gram orally, 3 times a day on alternate days to a total dose of 45 gram. It is also important to be on a very protein-rich diet, and you need to vitamins and iron for quick recovery. And another surgical method that's called cholangiopancreatography that involves removing of parasites by surgery. Now, what are the prevention methods? Should wash water-grown veggies thoroughly before the use of 6% potassium permanganate or vinegar for 10 minutes. And this helps kill the encysted metacercate. And should cook veggies, especially all water-grown vegetables, thoroughly before eating. And use of molluscides to prevent the transmission of the liver fluid. And vaccine by using hybridoma technology can be useful to prevent the infection in endemic areas. These are the reference books and these are the sites. And maximum photographs are captured from Google Image. Thank you, everyone.